Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to show how to emit particles from a texture. I'm also going to talk a little bit about theoretically making a height map and emitting it from that. So first, let's just make a quick object. Let's give it some geometry. And then I'm going to make like a quick mountain range. So I'm going to go into the polygons tab under edit mesh. We'll go to the transform component tool, set it to 1, and just pull up. So we've got some randomized geometry. I'm going to use the soft selection tool here just to get a little bit more of a mountain. And then we'll go back into object mode and do an edge loop select on those edges, and soft selection still on. There we go. I'm going to scale it to itself to flatten out those edges, and it looks like I can pull that down a little bit. All right, so now we've got our object built. We can smooth that out a little bit, and I'll give it some UVs. So some planar UVs based on the y-axis. And now let's put a texture on there. In fact, we could make this like a volcano. Pull that down, have that erupt as part of the particle demo here. Smooth it one more time. There we go. Now that'll be all right. So let's put a material on there. A Lambert. Let's delete the history. And on that Lambert, we're going to put a ramp. And on the ramp, I'm going to put a circular ramp. And so there we go. We've got some red from where the lava will be, and maybe some orange or yellow. Yeah, that's good enough. And then I'm just going to put black. I'll emit black. I can make the particles emit 0 particles if I have black. So just need to make sure that it erupts in the right area. So how do we do that? Well, let's just adjust the UVs a little bit. So we'll go under Edit UVs, UV Texture Editor, select this object, select some UVs, select the shell, and just nudge that shell around until we get that into the right spot. So let's see. That's pretty good. Now I can shrink that down just a little bit. All right, so now how do we make this erupt particles? Well, I'm gonna go F5 into the dynamics menu, and then I'm gonna go under particles, emit from object, and make sure that surface is selected. I'm gonna hit apply. And I could also say scale rate by object size. We're already working at a really high, sort of large size right now. So I'm probably pretty good. And if I scrub up, you can sort of see that I'm emitting particles. But I do want more particles. So I am going to turn on scale rate by size, and that's under the emitter tab. And we'll just put that to 1 and see if we're going to get enough particles. Oh yeah, way more than enough. Okay, probably too many particles. So yeah, that's good. All right, so now we just need to make it emit the same texture and emit 0. So in order to do that, you got to go into the particle shape node and give it a per particle attribute for opacity and color. So you do that by clicking here, and then you go back into the emitter attributes, scroll down to the bottom, say inherit color, inherit opacity, and enable texture rate. We need to plug in the ramp that we made into this particle color. So let's just go grab that. Clean that up, and grab those particles and middle mouse and drag that into the particle color. All right, moment of truth. Let's see if this is working. Yep, it is. Great. So, you know, if we wanted to make this work better, we could sort of go into the particle emitter and change the speed. We could also change the speed randomness, and then we could apply some really cool dynamic fields onto that, just a little bit of gravity or something, like a little light gravity, and so it would look like it would be coming up and then coming down in an arc. So anyways, that's just a real basic tutorial. And this will render out really nicely with hardware rendered particles. And to do that, you go under Window, Rendering Editors, Hardware Render Buffer. So you can see that's working fine. These are hardware particles and they won't render with a Maya software render. You can render out frames by going under Render Attributes, and then you can specify everything in here. And then when you're ready, you just go render sequence, and then it'll render whatever sequence you've got in here. All right, thanks so much for watching. One last thing about height maps. You could easily generate a ramp as a projection to get a height map off of a surface like this. But what you would probably need to do is render an overhead of that surface and then bake the texture in. You could probably do this for waves as well, but you again would probably need to bake that out before you had the particles come up, because particles won't emit from a projection, a texture projection. Okay, so that is all. Thanks so much for watching.